Hello dear children, today in this class we are going to continue the same lesson number 6, Call for Peace. In this part we are going to do the exercises from page number 59 and 60. So let's get started. Take out page number 59, question number A. Understanding the poem. Question number A. Choose the correct option to complete each statement. 1. Geechee Manido stretch his right hand over the warring tribes. The answer is right hand. Number 2. His voice was as powerful as far off waters falling into deep abysses. Number 3. Geechee Manido was not the king of the land. Number 4. He had filled the marshes with wild fowl. 5. The tribes were not content. Question number 2. That is number B. Answer the questions with reference to context. You will get after this pages. Let's look at vocabulary part. Question number A. Look up the meanings of the phrases given in the box in a dictionary. Then fill in the blanks with the correct phrases. Number 1. Matthew is at peace with the world ever since he gave up fighting. Next page, page number 60. Sheila got an ice cream for her sulking brother as a peace offering. The police told the crowd to keep the peace and listen to them calmly. Number 4. Shake hands teams and make peace. Number 5. The old lady installed a new burglar alarm system to get some peace of mind. Number 6. The rowdy boys were asked to leave the concert because they were disturbing the peace. Now, this is the question from understanding the poem. Question number B. Answer the questions with reference to context, which is in page number 59. Number 1. Looked upon them with compassion, with paternal love and pity. Number A. Who looked upon whom with compassion and pity? Answer, Geechee Manido looked upon his people with compassion and pity. Number B. Why did he feel compassion and pity? Answer, he felt compassion and pity by looking at their rage and wrangling. Number C. Why does he look upon them with paternal love? Answer, he looked upon them with paternal love because he considered his people as his own children. Number 2. Why then are you not contented? / Why then will you hunt each other? Number A. Why are the tribes not contented? Answer. The tribes were not contented because the other neighboring tribes were trying to capture their lands. Number B. Why were they hunting each other? They were hunting each other to secure their lands. Number C. Which figure of speech does the poet use in these lines? What effect does it create? Now, number C, which figure of speech does the poet use in these lines means, see the first line written in bold, why then are you not contented? Why then will you hunt each other? For these line the questions are asked. Answer is, the poet used interrogation in these lines. And the second part, what effect does it create? It create a dramatic effect. Means the poet is asking a question not for the sake of answer, but to keep his people engaged in thinking of what they are doing is really right. So, dear children, do this work from page number 59, question number A, and from vocabulary part also, question number A, you do it in the book, and question number B, answer the questions with reference to context, do it in your copy, neat and cleanly. Alright, thank you.